Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to another tutorial, and in this video we are going to talk about Navigator 2.0. We will try to use Navigator 2.0 with the easiest way possible using Velocity X, I'm going to use one of the examples which I already have done for an application which was for 30 Days of Flutter, a catalog app. So if you see here, this is running on web. And we can see right now this is a login page. We enter some data over here, we press on the login button and we go to this home page, and if we click here then we go to a detail page. But as of now you can see there are few issues with this, like, you know, even if you go to detail page the URL still says home. And if I try to, let's say if I have to directly go to detail page, there is no such way. So for example, if I want to do some deep linking in the future, I cannot do that. So that stuff can be fixed using Navigator 2.0, and that is little bit complex, but yes, we can solve it in a very easier way in this video. And the second thing which we want to do, we want to remove this hashtag from here, which is which makes it very ugly as a URL. So this URL needs to be without hash. That's the first priority, and then we will apply Navigator 2.0 so that even if you, let's say right now, even if you try login, that works, and home as well works. But the thing is that deep linking will not work, because if we click here, this pushes a new page, but the URL does not change. So those are the things which we are gonna change now. And also we want to apply some kind of query parameters if we can give. So all those of sort of things we will see. First of all, we have to remove the hash. So we will go to pubspec.yml, and here what we can do, we have already added VelocityX 2.6.0. I'll add another dependency here, which is URL strategy, if you will see here the name of this package. And what it will do for us, it will make it very easy for us to remove hash without doing much. So one second, yes, we are done with that. So we will go back to main.dart. Here we will import, let's say url strategy/url strategy.dart. And before run app, what we have to use is basically we can use set path url strategy. That's all you have to do. And then you have to do a hot restart, or maybe you can, for this case, we will restart the application by pressing F5. And what we have done is basically we have just written one single line, which is set path URL strategy, and the package will does all the job for us. So you don't have to worry about anything. And since Flutter Web is now in production, so these are the things which you will definitely need to do. And once we are done with this particular thing, yes, our app is almost started. And now you will see that there will not be any kind of hash in the URL. So now you can see slash login directly, and we can write something like this. We will press on login, we will go to home page, and this home page is also without slash, which looks good. And now what we have to do, we have to shift to Navigator 2.0 so that we can take the advantage of so many things. So you have to first of all come to Material app, where you specify your themes and every detail, like routes and all those things. So first of all you have to use Material app dot router, and then you won't be able to use these routes anymore. You won't be able to use initial route anymore, but rather you get something called router information parser. Okay, and here in this case you can use something called VX information parser, and that's what you have to write. Okay, and the second thing which you want is some sort of delegate, which is a router delegate, and here you can use something called VX navigator. It takes routes. Again, these routes are gonna be very much similar to your routes which is there, which we have already written in by Navigator 1.0 styling. So we'll just copy this. Let's just copy this. And although this will not work directly, so what this routes takes? Okay, let's see. So it takes a string and a page. So a string we have slash for example for login, and then it gives us two things. One is the URI. And the second thing it gives is dynamic, which is params. So for now, let's say we don't need anything, so we'll keep it blank. And every page which you want to use, you have to wrap it with Material page. Okay, that's the requirement. And that should be pretty simple. Similarly, we have a home route. If you'll see here, slash home, login route is slash login, detail route is slash detail, and cart route is slash cart. So now we have this as well. So we can just say something like this, comma slash or dash 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 comma dash dash. We will replace these values later. And then we have to wrap it with material page. So that's what I'm gonna do with all my pages. And now we are almost done, guys. Nothing else you have to do. We'll do a hot restart. And now you will see we still have the same kind of application. Like if we go to login, we can go to login, which is working pretty much fine. We'll click on login and now we are stuck. Because why we are stucking? Because we are trying to use the old way of navigation, which is navigator.push named context and myroutes.homeroute and all those things. Now, what you can do rather, if you're using VelocityX, you can use, let's say, context.vxnav.push. So this is almost the same. This time you have to just give it a URI, which is the route. So you can say URI.parse and the URI can be myroutes. And dot home route, and that's all you have to write. So push is the same thing. And now what it will do for us, now if I'll click over here with the credentials, let's say login, and this time it moved us to home page. Now it is pretty much good. Now what I want to do when I click on this particular item, rather than like using Navigator 1.0, it should use Navigator 2.0. That's the first thing. And the second thing is that it should also change the URL here. So how we will do that? So we will go back to main.dart. First of all, we don't have a detail route, right? So we have to add a detail route. So how we will add it? We'll just copy this home route. Here we can say home detail route or home details route. And rather than home page, we have a home details page. But the problem with this is that detail page needs an item, a catalog item. So we have to provide some item over here. Let's say, for example, it is right now null. And then we also receive some parameters here. So using this parameter, we have to give this catalog item, right? So what we can do, now we will go to this catalog list. This catalog list where we click on this list. And once we click on it, then it goes to the second page. So how we will do that? We will go to catalog list.dart. Here you can see we have a list view and a grid view, which is using the same thing, which is when you click on it, it does the same kind of stuff. So we can do one thing. We can just extract this as a widget. Oh, leave it for now. So we will change this inkwell navigator.push home detail page and all that stuff. Rather, we will say this time context.vxnav.push. And now you have to specify the URI. So URI this time is URI.parse. And we can use myroutes.homeDetailRoute, right? And also we want to pass some parameters. So params, and we can specify the catalog here. And using this catalog, we can pass that catalog using the params. So we can directly pass params over here rather than the null value. And now when we are done, now if you'll click over here, then you will see the detail here, right? Rather than home, we see a detail, and this looks fine, but you know, this is still incomplete, I would say. Why? Because this detail does not make any sense, but rather what we could do is basically we could provide an ID of this particular item. And when you click, when you go to this URL, basically, it should also change your ID, or it should be, there should be some way to add ID to this URL, right? So how we will achieve that? That's the more complex job, and that can help us with deep linking and all that stuff. For example, what I want to do, I have to go to this PlayStation 5, okay, via URL. So right now there is no such way of going to PlayStation 5, right? Because if I write slash detail, then you will see that nothing will come, because we are not passing anything over here. So this is a problem, and we have to fix this problem. So now how we will fix it? So home is with us. So what we have to do, rather than using home detail route, rather than home, let's use the home details route only. But this time when we go to catalog list, rather than saying uri.parse this thing, we can remove this uri.parse, but rather we will use something called path. So in the path part, we will provide this, for example, myroutes.homeDetailsRoute, right? We can also pass some query parameters. So the query parameter can be of like, you can just say ID, and ID can be, for example, your catalog.id, right? So this can be basically query parameter, where we can just say that this is the ID. And now if I go back to main.dart, we will get the URI here, but let's try to run it first. Let's see if that works. So now if I go here, if I click here, okay, nothing is working. We might be getting some error over here. Let's see. Yes, so it's saying iterable dynamic, but got one of type int and all that stuff. So now what's wrong over here? We will, first of all, we will just change it to URI. Let's say URI. And let's also break this down to block body. And now here, rather than saying params, because we are gonna remove the params, we can use the ID, and for example, we need the items. Using that ID, we will fetch the current item and then we will pass that item. Okay, how we will do that? Now that's the thing, right? So first of all, what we will do, we need a catalog here. So we will access the catalog using, let's say we will use vxstate.store, and I'll access my store, and from that I will get catalogs by ID, and I can use URI dot query parameters, and here I will get the ID, and I have to also parse it to int. So I'll say int dot parse, and now I should be able to get this catalog, and then I'll pass this catalog. Now let's see if this works or not. So we'll do a hot restart once, and then we are here again. And now if I click, oh, we are still getting this issue that iterable got one of type int. Something is not working here. So let's see what's not working by checking out. We are passing the query parameters pretty well. We are trying to push it as an integer. We have to just convert it to a string and then it should work. Okay, that was the mistake which we were doing. And now if I click on the iPhone 12 Pro, you can see the detail with the ID part as 1. So now if I go to PlayStation, you can see the ID is 4 of this particular item. Get rid of this. If we click here, you can see the details ID is equal to 1. And similarly, if you go to PlayStation 5, you can see detail ID is equal to 4, which means this thing is working perfectly fine. So that's how you can use Navigator 2.0. You can remove the hash from the URL, and everything which you want, you can do pretty much with this particular update of Velocity X. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, press the like button, subscribe to the channel, and also let me know in the comments if you have any questions. And yes, feel free to share with your friends as well. Bye-bye. I'll see you in the next one.